said in the video and I've said it 1,000 times. I've had a lot of incredible experiences along the way, but the one I was looking forward to the most, without question, was coming back and sharing my experience, my journey, and everything that I've been through with my hometown of Danvers, Mass. So this is very special. As a lot of you know, and I'm sure my family certainly, but I was a pretty rough kid when I was younger. I just had a strong personality. I never wanted to be told what to do. I never wanted to be told no. And that's still my personality a little bit. I've learned to use it appropriately as an adult. But, from a young kid, when I stepped on the ice in the Danvers Youth Hockey program, I probably say I grew up and I was trained for Danvers Youth Hockey from the Learn to Skate program all the way up until I went to high school and finished all the way through Bantams. But I started skating at such a young age, and I fell in love with hockey right away. I made it, my life, my everything. I wanted to play on every team, and I just continued to grow through Danvers Youth Hockey. But it wasn't until 1998 when U.S. women's team won a gold medal in the Olympics. It was the first time women's hockey had been in the Olympics. And I'll never forget it. I was, 11 years old. Parents let me stay up late. I think I went into school the next day late. Hopefully, maybe some of you guys got to watch our late game. But this game was played over in Japan. The U.S. team won a gold medal, and I remember after that, they came back. I was up at an event with my dad and my brother and sister at the King's Grant, actually. Not one of the players from the team. She was at the Touchdown Club event that night that we went to. She spoke. It was family night. And I don't know if anyone's seen that picture. It was floating around the internet a little bit the last couple of years, but it's a picture of myself with her. I was 10 years old. I had her jersey on and had her gold medal around my neck. And and from that day, I was 10, 11 years old, that was 20 years ago, and I told every single person I came into contact with, everyone, my family, my friends, my grandparents, everyone, I said, that's going to be me. I was 10 years old, and I said, I'm going to win a gold medal someday.
Yeah.
The last 4 years since the last Olympics have been incredible. It's been a lot of ups and downs with our team, and I'm really proud for what our team has stood for, what we've gone after, what we've been able to achieve together as a group. We thought for long and hard for 4 years about what our deeper purpose was and why and how we were going to win this gold medal. It's to inspire that next generation, to share the experience, to make hockey a better sport when we left it than when we came in, to make women's hockey a better sport. And I truly believe that's a big reason why our team was able to be successful in this Olympics and win a gold medal. And I'm so proud to be standing here today and sharing it with you guys because it means the world to me. It's been the greatest honor of my life representing this town. And thank you guys very much.